It was a chase last night that ended in gunfire, arrests, and a traffic nightmare in Portland. About a five-mile stretch of I-84 shut down in both directions starting last night and lasting through the morning commute. It all added up to a roughly 14-hour closure of a major interstate.
And we have learned that police had arrested one suspect and were chasing another connected to the murder of Kelso store clerk Kayla Chapman. Eventually, shots were fired, forcing the closure of the freeway until investigators were able to fully process the scene.
Now we're learning more about how those two new suspects are connected to the case. Fox 12's Kelsey Watts has the update.
You may remember DeAnthony Williams was arrested on January 23rd. Police say he's the one who shot and killed Kayla Chapman during that convenience store robbery. Now, according to new court records, we're learning he told his girlfriend the names of his two accomplices who were in that getaway car.
There are now three men under arrest tied to the robbery and murder of Kelso store clerk Kayla Chapman after this wild end to a police chase in the middle of I-84. Investigators shut down the freeway for hours Tuesday night after they say shots were exchanged with one of the suspects. ODOT cameras captured officers rushing to the scene where police arrested Erkinson Bossy only hours after fellow suspect Nanemi Ekiek was arrested in Vancouver.
It's just been crazy. I'm glad that they got caught.
Kayla Chapman was working at this Kelso market on the morning of January 22nd when she was shot and killed. The next day, DeAnthony Williams was arrested in Camas. Investigators say he's the one who robbed the store and killed Chapman, but he had accomplices in the getaway car. New court records show that Williams told his girlfriend Bossy gave him the gun and Nenim gave him the hat and bandana used as his disguise. Investigators say Bossy is Erkinson Bossy and Nenim is Nanemini Ekiek, who is now charged with first-degree murder and first-degree robbery.
All right, sir, you have the right to remain silent about this case, and you also have the right to be represented by a lawyer.
According to court records, Ekiek told police the whole thing started when the three men drove to Kelso to buy drugs, but they couldn't reach the dealer, so they decided to rob a store instead. Ekiek telling police that Bossy and Williams said they did not want to make the drive to Kelso for nothing. Records show the trio drove by four other stores looking for a place that wasn't crowded before deciding on Holt's Quick Check, where ultimately Chapman was shot and killed. Ekiek told police that after he saw the news coverage, he gave his hat to someone and instructed them to burn it. Records show he also admitted to saying they needed to burn the stolen getaway car.
And I've been praying for God to find these people and help they can get some help because she was a really beautiful person. And only 30 years old. I have a daughter that's 30 years old. She knew her. So that's all I can say.
The manager of the market where Kayla Chapman was killed tells us they are relieved now that the other suspects in this case have been caught. Chapman's grandmother tells us their family is happy with these additional arrests as well. She says, we hope they are convicted. Reporting in Kelso tonight, Kelsey Watts, Fox 12 Oregon.